In today's video, we're going to take a look at how we can manage our storage on the iPhone. See how much storage space we have left, as well as what is taking up that space, and then what we can do about it. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in these videos. Let's see how we can manage our storage on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, the first thing we're going to look at is how much space we have on our iPhone and how much space is available. To do that, we go over to our Settings app. From our Settings app, what we need to do is go over to General. Under General, you're going to see an option for iPhone storage. This is where we need to go. When we're looking at our iPhone storage, it's going to tell us how much space we have available, as well as how much is being used. And then we can also see what is using up all of that space. And then we can also manage it from here. So let's first look at how much space my iPhone has to do that, or how much space your iPhone has. To do that, what you do is you just go to the upper right-hand corner and you're going to see how large your iPhone is. So this is a 256 gigabyte phone. Now, what I have available to me is this little number here, 224. So I have a 256 gigabyte hard drive, and I have available 224. Now, a good rule of thumb here is to make sure that you have at least 10% of your storage available for the iPhone. If you have less than that, then what you want to do is you want to start removing some items. Every computer, including the iPhone, it is just a computer, every computer likes to have about 10% breathing room, if not more. So what we need to do is we need to make sure that this number here is not less than 10% of this number here. I'm well within the safe region there. But let's just say it was under 10%. What can I do? How do I manage my space? What is using up that space? Well, what we need to do is we just need to look down in this area here. We can see that my Consim 2 is using most of my space, or I should say that's what's using, or the largest file on my iPhone. It's using about 2 gigabytes. I also have Turmoil Plus, and that is using about 1.8 gigabytes. So this is sorted here by size. You're going to see it says size right here underneath my drawing there. You're going to see it says size right there. So I can easily see what is using up my space. Now, from here, what I can do is I can remove these apps, or what I can do is I can offload them. So let's go ahead and tap on Turmoil here. Let's say I don't play that game. So what I would like to do is remove it. I need to clear up some space. Now from here, what you're going to be able to do is see how much space the actual app is taking, as well as how much space the data is taking. In some cases, depending on the app, you might have more data than the app. Some apps are relatively small. But other apps, such as this app here, is relatively large. It's taking up 1.8 gig, while my data is only taking up 12 kilobytes. So we can easily see here what part of the app is taking up our space. So now how does that help us? Well, basically what we have here are two options. We can offload it, or what we can do is we can delete it. Now when we delete it, what it's going to do is it's going to get rid of all of the data as well as the app. So if you are no longer going to use that app at all in the future, then what I would recommend doing is deleting it. It's going to clear all of your data as well as the app. So in this case here, it'll clear all of this out here. Now, if you want to clear up space, but you don't really want to delete the user data, but maybe you don't use that app that often, what you can do is offload it as well. When you offload it, what it's going to do is remove the app. So in this case here, it's going to remove 1.8 gigabytes. It'll free up a good amount of space there. But what it's not going to do is delete the 12 kilobytes. So it's going to keep that. And then when you re-download that app, you're going to have all of your data there. So it doesn't delete your user data. So if I'm pretty far in this game, it's not going to, or I'm not going to have to start over again. So if it's an app that you're going to be using in the future, I would recommend offloading it. If it's an app that you know that you're not going to be using in the future, you don't care about the user data, then what I would do is I would delete it. Now, when you delete it, what it does do is it deletes it completely from your iPhone. It is no longer going to be on your iPhone. It's not going to be in your app library. It's just going to be gone. But when you offload it, let's go back over here. When you offload it, it doesn't necessarily remove it from your iPhone. At least it doesn't remove the icon from your iPhone. It's going to remove all of the app data, not the user data, but the app data. But it is not going to remove it from your iPhone. So let's go ahead and see what I mean. I'm going to remove turmoil here. So I'm just going to tap on offload app. It's going to offload it. So now what it's doing is it is removing that app. So it basically just freed up quite a bit of space on my iPhone. Now, if I search for turmoil, you're going to see that I can actually find that app. And you can see it right down here. If I go to the app library, you're going to see that I have, we'll just go down here to T's, you're going to see that I have turmoil here. So I still have access to it, but before I can open it up, remember that app is not on my iPhone. So what I need to do is I need to download it. So what I would do is I would just tap on this whole thing here, and it'll download it, and then it'll open it up. So we can easily see here that this one needs to be downloaded because we have the little download icon there. Let's go there. I covered that up with my drawing there. So we can easily see that that needs to be downloaded. Also, when it is on your home screen, let's go ahead and move this to my home screen. I just tap and I drag it. When I move it to my home screen, you're going to see that I have a little cloud there to the left of the name. So this is telling me that this is not on my iPhone. So if I wanted to load it again, if I wanted to play this game, what I would do is I would tap on it, and now it is loading it up. And then I'll be able to play it. All of my data will be there. Now, in addition to viewing your apps by size, we can also view them by when they were last used. This can come in handy to look for apps that you are no longer using. You probably have some really old apps in there that you haven't used in quite a long time. How can you find out what those are? Well, all you have to do is just tap on this, and now it's going to sort them by last used date. And then all you have to do is just swipe up, select Show All, and it's going to show you all of the dates in chronological order by when they were last used. So what you can do is you can just swipe up and look for your last used apps, and maybe you want to delete those too because you no longer need those. And again, it works the same way. Let's say that I'm not using Plantify. What I can do is I can offload it, or what I can do is I can delete it. So I still have the same options. It's just a different view. I can view them by the last used date, or I can view them by size. And then, of course, you can also view them by name if you want to do it that way. So then you can just swipe up. It is in alphabetical order. But I think the two important ones are size and last used date. Now, another thing you can do if you're running low on space is make sure that you're using iCloud Photo Library. When you use an iCloud Photo Library, what it's going to do is it's going to offload all of your photos into iCloud. And this can free up quite a bit of space. I have about 250 gigabytes of photos, but on my phone, on my personal phone, I think it's taken up maybe 10 gigabytes. It's not taken up a lot of space because it's all stored in the cloud. All the high-resolution versions are stored in the cloud. The nice thing about this is when you do use this, what it'll do is it'll download the high-res versions if you want to edit it, and then what you can do is edit it, and once you edit it, what it'll do is it'll upload the edited version back into the cloud and then give you the low-res version. It's all seamless. You don't really have to worry about anything. So where do we turn this on? Well, basically what we need to do is we need to go to our settings again, and then we go over to Photos. Under Photos, you're going to see iCloud Photos. I'm a big fan of iCloud Photos. When this is turned on, what it'll do is it'll just upload all of your high-res versions into the cloud, as I mentioned before. Now, there's one caveat with this. it can take up space. So what you may need to do is purchase more space, which you probably would probably need to do anyway. Apple doesn't give you a lot of space. 5 gigabytes is not a lot of space. So what you need to do is you need to go to your iCloud settings here. And then what you do is you go over to iCloud, and under iCloud, what you're able to do is manage your account storage. So from there, what you're able to do is upgrade your storage, and then you can store all of your photos in the cloud. I'm a big fan of using iCloud Photo Library. So those are some ways that you can manage your storage on your iPhone. Basically, this is all done through the Settings app. You just go to Settings, go to General, and then you're going to see your storage options. From there, you're going to be able to see how much storage you're using, how large your iPhone is, and you're going to be able to see what apps are taking up that storage. You can do this by size or by when they were last used. And then from there, if you no longer need an app, you can offload it. It'll keep the user data, but it'll remove the app. Or what you can do is just delete it all together. Then it'll just remove everything. So those are some ways that you can manage your storage on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, as I mentioned in the beginning, I'll tell you a little bit more about me and how you can help support my efforts. I create these easy-to-follow video tutorials. I have about 400 of them on YouTube, but I have about 2,000 of them on my website, danstutorials.com. I have been working on my website a lot longer than I have been on YouTube. Now, the way that you can help support this is by joining my membership on the site. When you join my membership on the site, you will get all of my videos, all 2,000 of them. You'll get all of them ad-free, so you're not going to see any of the ads. You also get access to my AI assistant. I have an AI assistant that I made to act like it's an Apple genius. So if you have questions, you can easily ask the AI assistant for any genius type questions. I also host webinars on a regular basis, usually 2 to 3 a month, and you have access to those as well. And then the last thing is you're helping support a small business. I work out of a corner office in my house, and it's just myself, along with my wife who works for Susan G. Komen. So if you like what you see here, you have a few benefits when you become a member of my site. So that's a little bit about me and also how you can manage your storage on the iPhone.